And as far as that go, I mean, you know, once again, I welcome y'all. And I'm here in St. Louis and live and living color with my brother Talib.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for, a change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ibn Rod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. President Trump has already had sit-downs with the wrong representatives of the black community. How about a real discussion with a true grassroots African American? Join and organize Operation Exodus Mississippi today, or become a supporter.
And that is all Angel Nup Nup 7 has been saying.
Down the road.
Is to get people that think like he does. I'm going to tell you the truth.
Down the road.
He really does care about black women and black men. Black people as a whole. He really does care. But what he has been talking about
down the road
is getting black people into positions that think like he does.
Come on, Dorothy. Don't you carry nothing that might be alone. Come on.
That's what he's talking about.
There it is.
Nobody's being delivered from anything. God ain't doing nothing for nobody right now.
Ooh, oh, 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 oh. This whole thing about racism, white supremacy, you really don't take it serious. So you play on Facebook and you play on YouTube. You just play like little children. The only way that the so-called Negro, the only way that the Aboriginal, the only way that the African, whatever you call yourself, the only way you're going to get serious is that all of this stuff that we got going on get taken away from you. Take your job away. Take the water away. Take the food away. Take everything away from you. And let the people begin to group up in their tribes. The white tribe, the Mexican tribe, the new people that's coming here, they are in that tribe, and everybody fighting over the little water and the little food that's available. Get in your tribes. You're not going to care nothing about a Mercedes Benz because you can't eat it. You can't drink it. All this material stuff that y'all love, all the money in your pocket that you brag about, not going to mean nothing when there's no resources, when you don't have no water, when you don't have food, when there's no electricity, no gas, all the comforts that y'all used to. Y'all a bunch of spoiled Negroes. And that's why you can't get nothing serious. That's why you can't get serious with the Mississippi campaign, OEM, Operation Exodus Mississippi. You can't get serious. You don't want to help. You just want to sit back in the cut and cheerlead. You think I'm going to do all the work. You think those who want to help me get together, you want us to do all the work and your happy ass sit back in the cut and don't do nothing like the little red hen. You want me to put the seed in the ground. You want me to take care of the wheat as it grow up and get rid of the weeds and make sure that the wheat grows nice. And I harvest the wheat and I grind the wheat into flour. And I bake the cake and I bake the bread and the pies. And the only thing you want to do with your happy ass is come behind us and eat pies and cakes and all that. No, that ain't happening. I'm not doing that. Like I told you in an earlier video of mine, we want to make a wall of shame for all you Negroes. And the ones that... you know that this is the way to go, but you don't want to do it because you're jealous, you envy, or whatever your reason is. But when the pie and the cake get done, there's going to be a wall just for y'all. You're going to be famous, and you're going to live forever on this wall. Your name on the wall of shame. Pathetic losers. Wow, brother, you're so angry. Yes, I am. I'm angry because these... Aboriginal, these Africans, whatever the hell you want to call yourself, y'all piss me off because you ain't about nothing. You're a bunch of pathetic losers. I'm a winner. I like to win. I don't want to pretend to be a winner. I want to win. That's how I roll. I'm a winner. Y'all want to pretend to be a winner. You want to pretend to be a god. You want to pretend to be a goddess and a king and a queen and all that. I don't want to be that. You don't have to question me. If I tell you I'm God, you see it. If I tell you I'm a king, you see it. I don't even have to say it. You said, that guy acts like he's God. That guy acts like he's a king. Well, I guess he is because you're going to respect me, whether you like it or not. Because that's how I roll. I'm a winner. When I was playing basketball, and you had those who make mockery, those who think that they are Michael Jordan and LeBron James, and then I come on the court and beat the hell out of them. How did you do that? Because I'm a winner. I don't care who you are. Michael Jordan, LeBron James, I don't care who you are. I don't see you better than me. I don't see you as greater than me. You on the opposite team, far as I'm concerned, you're going to lose. That's how I roll. Brother, what brings you to all this anger? What is grinding your gears? What's grinding your gears? Here I am. I'm on a page. I forgot exactly what page I was on YouTube. Playing on YouTube, you know. Like y'all like to do. Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. Y'all likes to play. Here I am. I'm trying to promote OEM. I'm trying to promote Operation Exodus Mississippi to this nutcase. And for some reason, I don't know how this nutcase done it. I don't know how this got into the conversation. I'm trying to talk about the Mississippi campaign, and this nutcase talks about, well, you need to be an African. I'm like, what? First of all, watch the video. I want you to watch. Would you please watch Soul Liberation Day 2019? Would you please watch the promotion videos for Operation Exodus Mississippi? That's what I'm telling this silly troll person. And they keep talking about, well, it can't work unless you are African and people are insane if you don't believe. What is your damn problem? What is your problem? This is the bottom line. This is the reality. Y'all African nutcases. You want to be so damn African. You don't speak no African language. You don't dress like an African. You eat no African food. You don't do nothing African. And plus, you can't do nothing African because African is a continent. It's a continent, people. What people are you trying to be? You don't know. You believe you are an African, but you don't know. If you say, I believe I'm an African, that means you know and you really don't know. It's up in the air. Same thing with this Aboriginal stuff. You don't believe that we are natives? If you know, you don't have to believe. So if you know, then you can break down all the tribes, the people. Show your relatives. You're not going to show your relatives. You don't know no damn people. None of this. Who told you you was an African? The white man, the liar, the deceiver. He's the one that told us that we was Africans, and we went with that narrative. None of these African people know, from none of these countries is telling us or told us or taught us that we were Africans. However, now I must confess, and I heard through the grapevine as I was growing up, I did hear different people talk about how the so-called Negro, these black people, are natives. Mind you also that this Peckerwood, these racist devils in this country, also called the native people here Africans. Explain that. They called them Africans also. They also called them Negro. Who else do they call Negro? I wonder. But this is the bottom line. Whether you are Aboriginal, whether you are African, Aboriginal, African, two words that start with the letter A. Another word that start with the letter A is as. You are an ass because when it's all said and done, the Peckerwood kicked the Africans in the ass and the Aboriginals in the ass. Both of them. You both are losers. You want me to find some kind of pride? You talk about, oh, you stuck in slavery. We didn't come from no. You're still a loser no matter how you look at it. The white man, the Caucasian, these pink racists, kicked the Africans in the ass, still doing it today. Kicked the Aboriginal people in the ass, still doing it today. you a damn slave. You under their control. So the only thing that you can do, because you have no power, is to play on Facebook and YouTube all day. Because you don't have no power, you don't have nothing else to do. You're a fake king, you're a fake god, all that stuff. You're not real. You're a bunch of pathetic losers. You don't like me saying that? Prove different. Become a king. Become a god. The only way that you can do it is that you have to support OEM, the Mississippi campaign. It's the only way that you get on the path in that direction. Everything else, y'all loser ass, you keep trying to work it, it don't work. That's not my fault. The reason why I exist, the reason why there's a Mississippi campaign, is because all that other stuff ain't taking you nowhere. Feel good rhetoric. You feel good. I'm Aboriginal. I'm African. This feel good stuff. And this racist murdered all of them, the Africans and the Aboriginal people, wiped them out. And here you are, you're so damn smart, you're so damn intelligent, and you still under their control. You live with the racists. You don't live with no Africans. You don't live with no Aboriginal. You live with the white man. And you proud to have his money in your pocket, his degree on your wall, you drive his cars, you go to work for his happy ass every day, and you got the nerve. Here I am, trying to tell us, trying to get us in a position to take this serious. We have something that can change our condition, and you know something? Because you really don't want. You like being a Negro slave. That's the bottom line. The only way that y'all gonna change, gotta take Facebook away from you, YouTube, your job, everything away from you, leave you with nothing. That's the only way you're going to take anything serious. Because as long as you're comfortable, as long as you get your 3 meals a day, as long as you get to play on Facebook and YouTube and all these childish games that y'all like to do every day, you don't take nothing serious. Your condition is not going to change. In fact, your destiny is going to be a mass grave. That's where you're on your way. All your Aboriginal nutcases is going into a mass grave. All y'all African wannabe Negroes is going to a mass grave. The Peckerwood and some of these other suckers gonna put all of you in the same grave. African Aboriginal unity at last. That's where you're on your way. That's where you're on your way to, because you don't take nothing serious. You want to keep playing games. I'm not nothing to play with. Serious as a heart attack. I'm not interested in whether I'm an African or an Aboriginal. I'm interested in being liberated from an oppressor. All that other stuff, y'all can fight over later on. Because the bottom line is, Aboriginal or African, you're a bunch of slaves under white supremacy. So don't watch this video for too long, because you might be late going to the white man's job, paying the white man's taxes with your Aboriginal African ass.
According to the modern definition of terrorism as outlined by the Department of Homeland Security, black people collectively have always been terrorists to white supremacy. Runaway slaves were terrorists against white supremacy and oppression. Harriet Tubman was a terrorist, Nat Turner was a terrorist, DeMarc Vesey was a terrorist, and all other slave rebellions were form of terrorist activity. Marcus Garvey was a terrorist, Malcolm X was a terrorist, and the Black Panthers were terrorists. The hip-hop movement of the 1980s and 1990s was a terrorist movement. Therefore, any and all Negroes caught studying the works of these terrorists will be immediately suspended from UCU. You will also be taken to Guantanamo Bay for further processing.
Oh, wow, wow, wow. What a happy day. Happy, happy, joy, joy. Happy, happy, happy. Happy, happy, happy. Happy. How you do that dance? Happy, happy, joy, joy. Happy. Happy, happy. What a happy day. What a happy day. What's so happy? Well, I'm not. Look. Oh, if you don't know by now, this is the Realities Tip on Earth. And of course, I'm your soul brother, number one, Angel Snub number seven. And it is a happy day. Happy. How you do that dance? How you do that? Happy, happy, John. What a happy day. What a happy day. I'm so happy for these African wannabe. They think they're Africans. I'm happy for you. Have you heard the news? Joy, joy, joy. Happy, happy. Man, I'm so happy for these people. Because they're getting ready to leave. These African wannabe black power type folks. Yo, they're getting ready to leave. That means more jobs for you and me. All of us who are unemployed. There are going to be a lot of jobs. Because these people that are talking all that pro-African, I'm an African, African is so great, I'm moving to Africa, they getting ready to leave. Yes! I'm so happy for them. They finally getting what they want. Oh, brother, what you talking about? You don't know what I'm talking about? Oh, wow. The world needs to know. Ghana, the African nation of Ghana, not Africa. Africa is a continent. The nation of Ghana on the continent of Africa. I don't know what an African is. I know that you can be a person that live on a continent and you call an African because you live on a continent. But there is no people. There's no tribe. There's no living thing on the planet called African. That's so dumb. But anyway, that's not my concern. Only thing I know is I'm so happy for y'all brothers and sisters. Africa's so great. Now you get, oh wow. This is so historic. What a wonderful day. Oh, what a, I'm so happy for God Nollywood Jr. Shout out to God Nollywood Jr. Brother Bakari, Brother Craig, all these guys that love Africa, they getting ready to leave. Man, wow. I'm so happy for you guys. The Prophet of Doom, Sarah Sunseti, and all these people that love Africa, go to Africa, and you want your resources, you want the mineral, you getting ready to go get it. This is so wonderful. This is a wonderful thing. I'm like, I want to rock with you all night. Dance you. Man, this is, I'm not happy for me. Because unfortunately, I don't know. If these guys, oh wow, they're getting ready to move to Ghana. They're going to Africa. Look, I just read an article. Well, not read an article. I just saw a video. And there is an article also, I believe. And you want to know something? This is not new information. It's new to me. But the African nation of Ghana is urging people like the RBG nation, all y'all RBGs, the RBG nation, and people like that, urging people of African heritage, that don't include me, because I don't make that claim. All you guys, Africa's so beautiful, and you know all about it, it's a wonderful place to go. You can make room for the Africans that's leaving, the people of Ghana that's leaving Ghana, and leaving other nations in on the continent. They are happy to come and take your place, and you can go ahead to Ghana. Ghana urges those living here in America of African heritage, I think really anywhere on the earth, if you are of African heritage, Ghana urges you to come back home. Wow, ain't that great? So you can see your grandmothers, and you can see your fathers, and your great-grandmothers, and all those people on the continent that love you. Now, you don't know who the hell they are. You don't know who your relatives are. But anyway, you just get to go to Africa and enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself with Africa. Enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself with Africa. I say enjoy yourself. Y'all gonna, woo! I am so happy for you. Brother, you making mockery. How am I making mockery? Tell me, how am I making mockery? That's where you want to go. That's the place to be. So how am I making mockery? I'm happy for you. You should, why are you getting upset? I'm sharing the joy. So now, Ghana is urging those of African descent. I think this message is being directed towards the descendants of slaves born in America. Ghana is saying that you can come home. So now here's your opportunity to go home. They have been working on the visa process to make it easy for you to go. They have different programs. Really, there's no excuse. There's no excuse. They are setting up programs and things so that you can make your transformation from a Negro to an African. Woo! What a wonderful day! What a wonderful day! I'm so happy to get you cats out of the way. I'll be so happy when y'all gone. Y'all pro-black, love Africa, whatever that stuff. I'll be glad when you gone. I love you, but that's what you want to do. That's where you want to go. Bye-bye. Adios, amigos. Am I being mean? Now, come on now. For real. I'm just... Brother, you know you're making mockery. Why am I making mockery? These people say they are Africans. These people say they want to go home. They are going home to their Africa. So I'm not making mockery. I am happy for you. I'm happy for you. How can I help? Can I donate to the program that will get your happy ass to Africa? I'll be happy to send in my donation. Get the hell out of here because you don't want to be here. You are an African. Go be, you won't be African. You're going to be a citizen of Ghana. There is no people, there is no nation called Africa. You will become a citizen of Ghana. Now, mind you, you're not going to get any land. You're not going to get nothing. They're going to assist you a little bit. That's all. You're not going to get any land. You are going to be subject to the rules, the policy, and the laws, even the religious beliefs of that nation. That's where you're going. No matter where on the continent that you go, that's where you will be subject to. You're going to leave the outright control of races, which is a good thing. And now you will go to your second slave master, which will be the government of Ghana. And you will do, and you will obey their laws and their rules and their policy. Enjoy yourself. Be happy. You will be in a place where you say you want to be. They are offering you no land. You have no say-so in nothing. You probably can't vote. You get nothing. The only thing you will get is you can wake up all the time and you don't see no racist, pink racists running around. That's good. I mean, that's a good thing. But you are in a foreign land. And you will not, you think that you're going to live in heaven. But anywhere on the planet you go, you're going to face problems. At least in America, you know what your problem is. You just don't want to deal with them. You just want to complain. And you want to feel good. So talking about Africa is how you feel good about the situation. Because you and me both know y'all ain't going nowhere. Guy Nollywood Jr. ain't going to Africa. Brother Bakari ain't going to Africa. Brother Craig ain't going to no Africa. Sarah Sutton said he is not going to live in no Africa. All these people, the Prophet of Doom is not going to leave New York or New Jersey, wherever he's living. He's not going to Africa. It's all feel-good rhetoric. The same stuff, the same feeling y'all get when you was in church hooping and hollering because you got the Holy Ghost. Same stuff. Because the reality of it is that continent of Africa and its people is foreign to you. Some of us can get on an airplane and we can go, and as an individual, we can do some things. So y'all individuals, go do y'all thing. Hey, I'm telling you, I'm happy for you. I'm glad that you're getting what you want. But the reality is, the 40 to 70 million soul brothers and sisters in this nation don't relate to no Africa, not interested in going to no Africa, because this is their home. And they still claim African ancestry. They might claim Aboriginal ancestry, whatever they claim. This is all they know. And they are not ready to pack up their bags and go to a foreign place where basically you have to start all over again from scratch. If you do things right and understand who you are, you can bring and develop and gain something for yourself upon the soil that you know. Because nothing is going to happen upon foreign soil among a people you don't know. So to go to Ghana, you will become a Ghanaian. You will become a citizen of Ghana. You will not be an African. You will be an African simply because now you're living on the soil, but there's no people called African. You will be Ghanaian. Or you will be a Somali citizen or somebody from the Congo, Congolese, and so forth. There's no such people as African. That's soil. Africa's not alive. It's a landmass. It's a continent. Who are you trying to be? Well, one thing for sure, yeah, I'm making mockery to a certain point, but I'm happy for those who are ready to go because they're serious. You and I all know Sarah Sutton said it, all the people that I'm talking about, they are not serious. Because now, here's your opportunity. God, I said, come home. And they will assist you, but they're not going to take care of your happy ass.
A new message has arrived.
They're not going to take care of you. And that's what you want. You want YouTube, you want Facebook, you want somebody to take care of your happy ass, just like the pink racists take care of you, give you money, give you food, water, and take care of your happy ass. And that's what you want to do. Ghana is not going to help you like that. They're gonna assist you, but they're not going to take care of you like you've been taken care of in the good old racist United States of America. But hold on. But again, it's a happy day, and it should be joyous. But these folks not serious because God has said, come home. So, let's go. Go. Bye-bye. Write me a letter. I'll write you back. We can be pen pals. a Negro and an African. I'm just waking up, I'm involved in some activity, and I watched a video by a fellow longtime YouTuber, and I just wanted to piggyback off of that. And this YouTuber goes by the name of Prophet of Doom. And I want to say this very quickly. I like the Prophet of Doom. I like this brother, have so for years. He's very unique. I like that other brother, the Mad Head Doctor. Subscribe to the Mad Head Doctor. Subscribe to the Prophet of Doom. These brothers are very, to me, unique. Of course, we have our differences, no doubt. And recently, my relationship with the brother, Prophet of Doom, I don't know, I think he's in New York, or is it Chicago? I think he's in New York. Anyway, this myself and this brother, we've known each other for a while, and we're probably around the same age also. But, you know, well, you don't know, I'm going to tell you. That's just something people always say. Well, you know, no, I know you don't know, I have to tell you. In recent times, due to my rejection that the descendants of slaves born in America are Africans, a lot of people just don't like that. They do not like for you to say that so-called black people are not Africans. They don't like that. They get really, really upset. You are in denial of your African ancestry and all like this. But then when you raise certain questions, they don't answer these certain questions. You're supposed to just believe, just like these people that want you to believe in Jesus, want you to believe in God, belief, belief, and belief. They want you to believe in stuff, but when they cannot answer legitimate, valid questions, they get angry and upset and think because they get angry and upset that you're supposed to just, oh, okay, I'm an African. Oh, okay, I'm an Aboriginal. Oh, okay, I'm an American citizen. Oh, okay, I'm a Christian. Oh, that's not how things work. In order for me to embrace this African thing, I've been taught all my life, I know about it. In order for me to embrace the things that you're talking about, you got to prove it to me. I don't want to believe in nothing. I want to know. And if you don't or cannot get me to the point where I feel good in knowing, I'm not going to go that direction, because otherwise I'll be like you, getting angry because somebody rejects what I'm talking about. I want to know. You don't know. But even so, we must understand that we will never be the same. We will always have our differences. The problem with the so-called Negro in America is you and I, well, not me, you have a problem with people being different because you want to be like your slave master. You want them to, you want to be able to tell somebody what they should do, how they should think, what they should eat, when they take a dump, when they take a leak. You want to control somebody's damn life, just like your slave master. You don't want people to have the ability to say yes or no. You want to run their life. You're not going to run my life. I'd rather be dead, and I'll fight you tooth and nail. You're not going to force crap on me that I don't believe in. I'm not interested in. When you come to this channel, and as long as Angel Snub Nub 7 has been in existence, I've never gotten angry. I don't get upset when people reject or don't like what I say. I'm not trying to force you to believe in nothing. I'm not trying to convert you to nothing. I only state my opinion, and I will defend my platform. That's all that I do. But you are my brother. You are my sister. We have a common enemy. We have common problems, and that's where we should concentrate our attention. I love my Hebrew Israelites. I love my Moors. I love my Christians. I love my Muslims. I love my Nation of Islam. I love our people, period. Even those who dislike me. That's your personal problem. Because I have no hate towards you. My hatred is toward an oppressor. My hatred is towards an oppressive system that refuses to view me as a human being, have exploited my ancestors, become rich on my ancestors, and continue to seek and cause me harm in some shape or form. Y'all got to get over. You got to get over this. You cannot tolerate people's differences of opinion. Oh, you stupid because you don't believe you're African. Oh, you an idiot because you don't believe you're an Aboriginal. Or you don't believe in Jesus or whatever y'all problem is. Y'all some sick folks. And as long as you think that way, you're going to get what's coming to you. And that's the mass grave. That's your extinction. And perhaps that's what's good. Maybe it's a good thing. Because if this is the best that we can do, you don't justify your life, so you shouldn't even exist. Good riddance to bad rubbish. So we need to get over this stuff. Because somebody don't believe what you're talking about. Hell, some of y'all, really, if you push it, some of y'all don't even believe it. If you was put on trial, trying to force your crop, then you ain't forcing nothing on me. And I'm damn sure not going to try to force nothing on you. Live your life to the best that you want to live. Make your decisions. The only thing I want to do is suggest. That's all. And give advice. Suggest it. You can take it or let it alone. But we still cool. Unfortunately, many of you aren't like that. But going into the topic that I wanted to speak about, I wanted to piggyback off this brother's video. Don't do it. Don't do it. Go to the Prophet of Doom channel and watch his video. Don't do it. And in the beginning of the video, it's a bunch of videos put together showing different persons who have committed some heinous crimes, most of them murder, rape, and whatever. And now they have to suffer the consequences of their actions. And they are facing long sentences. And all of them are crying. All of them are crying. I don't really have to watch a video. I spent 10 years locked up. And I saw guys crying when they began to understand, you're going to be here a long time. I cried myself. But I never tried to be a tough guy. I never ran around here talking about or trying to pretend like I'm some tough guy and I run around here want to kill people and raping folks and all that. I never pretend to be a tough guy. I cried because I prayed to my God and my God did not answer. All these guys did not answer. I tried to be a good person, a righteous person, and God will allow me to suffer like this. I understand that God does things in his good time. But after 3 years, after 4 years, after 5 years, after 6 years, when are you going to do something to help your servant? All my life, I try to do good. And this God didn't do nothing for me. Nothing. And yeah, I cried. I cried because of my disappointment in God. And I cried for myself because there was a good chance I would die in this place. And so these guys on video come to the realization they have no choice but to accept the reality that they are going to be locked away, chances are, for the rest of their life or the majority of their life for what they have done. Many of these people, before they are sentenced, and I saw these guys, it was this one guy, supposed to be some kind of gang member, whatever, I don't know what he was. He came in the joint, talking, he was bragging about what he did, because he killed another person. You know, flashing the gun sign. Yeah, man, I had to take care of my business. Nobody disrespect me. You know, showing, you know, throwing up the gang signs, whatever. Talking tough. You mess with me, nigga, I'll kill you too, right here in this place. Then one day, I saw him coming out of a meeting, tears in his eyes, he was crying, because he thought if he pleaded insanity, he was just going to come into the crazy house, spend a few months, and get out. This is the state of Missouri. This is the state of Missouri. They don't play that. When you plead insanity in the state of Missouri, they can hold you from 24 hours to the rest of your life. I will say that again. They can hold you for 24 hours to the rest of your life. And when he began to realize he could be in this place the rest of his life, guzzling down all these psycho drugs, he came out crying. It was a little rich, well, he wasn't rich, but like middle-class white boy. He was there for a little while, and he was making fun of this brother when he was crying because his brother was all tough, and now he was like, man, that dude is a bee. Look at him crying like a bee. And he's not the only one. You're going to be locked up in a place the rest of your life, and you might come out your door, and somebody has hung themselves on a doorknob and they dead as hell. Rigor mortis has set in. You in a place, people banging their head on the wall and blood everywhere. You in a place where you can't even really sleep good because you might wake up somebody trying to choke you to death. You in a place that anything can happen to you. It's not like prison, but you are in a place where things might not go well for you. So I admit, I confess, I cry. Especially when you realize you're going to die here. So you have these guys in this situation. They tough. I don't give a damn. Well, the justice system don't give a damn either. And now they have to seek the reality. So the lesson here, if you can't do the time, don't do the crime. Watch that video. But I want to take it one little step further. Because we, as descendants of slaves born in America, you refuse to do what is correct. You refuse to do what is appropriate. And you're going to get what's coming to you. And you want to laugh and you might make mockery of these guys, but we as a people are in the same situation. Living with these races is a crime. And if you can't do the time, don't do the crime. We've been doing this crime going on 500 years, and you've been laying around here just like these people. We've been laying around in this damn jail. So don't get high and mighty and make mockery or want to laugh at these guys that's in lockup, because we as a people just living in America, living with racists, we locked up. And you should be crying, and you should want to get out of this situation. And the answer to open the door to freedom is right here. It's called OEM. It's called Operation Exodus Mississippi. Mm-hmm.
Yo, man, $20 this clown gonna miss this shot.
Bet it up.
Martin? Malcolm? Here?
Pop, what did you expect?
Biggie, what the hell are you talking about?
Master J, do you expect them to let some rappers speak the situation? The politicians? The preachers? The music?
Yeah, we got our hands full with BET. Man, let's play.
Greetings, Doc.
Hello, Malcolm.
Shall we get down to business?
Yes.
What are you gentlemen having?
Ray, Ray Charles?
Yes, sir. In the flesh. Well, I met this fella named Tupac, and he told me about mixed masters and mixologists. Later on, they came and asked me if I wanted to come down and help change the music scene. But management didn't keep up with terminology. So when I said I wanted to be a mixologist, they sent me back as a bartender. What do you gentlemen have?
I have a coke.
What the hell? Give me a crown on the rocks. I've already died for Negroes once. This time it'll be for me.
Coming right up.
How do you know you're serving the right drinks, Ray?
Oh, that's easy. The labels are in braille.
Martin, whose vessel are you occupying?
Some guy named T-Mot. He calls himself a different kind of preacher and loves to say, I don't give a damn. Whose vessel are you in?
Brother called Talik Ibn Roth. I used to call white man devil. He calls them white racist Caucasian. Let's get down to business. Did they brief you after you were awakened?
Yes. Yes, they did. All that we worked and died for is being erased day by day. Marriage is becoming a thing of the past. I guess it's due to the black-on-black crime. You have to distinguish which race you're talking about these days in the black community. More brothers seek to engage in criminal activity day by day, and there are more fatherless children than I have ever seen before, even when I was alive. The sad part is that all we died for was so that we would have equal rights and equal opportunity. Now, they no longer even value an education. And that is required in order to even take advantage of opportunity when it comes.
Yes, you're right. I also see that the government is complicit in the undermining of the family. Not just blacks, but their own as well. They engage in social programming that lull our people into a false sense of security. Instead, they should be opening doors that have been closed to us since slavery. We were not looking for handouts. We were seeking justice and equal opportunity. What have our people done to themselves?
Malcolm, you once said that the Republicans and Democrats were like a wolf and a fox, both members of the K-9 family. According to my briefing, they both have been responsible for destroying all that we worked for. The sad part is that our own people in government helped them.
Yes, they did, Martin. If good men do nothing, these so-called black leaders will continue to aid in our people's destruction.
Did they show you the Council of 12 show where we interviewed Pamela Stevenson?
Pam said it's the people who put them in office that refused to hold them accountable.
That is why we're here, Malcolm, to set this thing right.
I agree. I have some house cleaning to do as well. We must stop these blacks from attacking each other verbally. Sadly enough, these two clowns would have had more credibility if they had settled their differences in private like we done.
I agree.
What about the guys that picked up after us?
What about them? If they were doing their job, we'd still be resting in our celestial dirt nap.
Right. Let's take care of business.
Historical topics, non-historical topics, and culture. eyes to the world that is around you, because what you see is not always what it appears to be. And I just want to share this knowledge with other people. I don't want to keep it all to myself. That's why I created this Patreon account. I want to share my writings, my commentaries, my views about many political topics, about many religious topics, about many occultic topics. That's pretty much it.
First annual PPU retreat and vacation was an absolute success. To come out of the virtual world, the online world, and into a tangible one where we can hug each other and look into each other's eyes and share even more intimate, vulnerable moments and spaces, laugh together, cry together. I mean, we were on an emotional roller coaster that brought us into an even deeper space of fulfillment. We broke bread together. We supported each other in the most interesting moments. We built our dreams together. It was such a beautiful experience, and I look forward to building with this family for years to come.